Hi, this is Chelsea from Ref and Write. In this video, we will learn how to write the conclusion section of your research paper. The conclusion is the last section of your research paper. This is the place to provide the final take-home message to your readers. Some journals require a separate conclusion section, whereas in some journals, the last paragraph of the discussion section is kind of treated as a conclusion. This section typically contains the following components. You can start by reminding your readers about the aims and objectives of your work. You must keep it brief and preferably in one or two sentences. Then you can highlight the overall findings of your work and explain what we have learned from your study. Then you can talk about the importance and significance of your findings. Finally, you can finish up by talking about the future implications and possible applications of your work. Here is an example. The authors are starting their conclusion paragraph with a single line summary of their work. They are saying that the objective of their research was to investigate the effect of natural light in office buildings. Then they are explaining what they have learned from their work. They're saying that they have found a link between natural light and the productivity of employees. Then they are explaining the future applications of their findings. They are saying that the results of this study will be helpful in the design and construction of future office buildings. Here is another example. The authors are starting the conclusion passage with the major findings of their research. They are saying that their study has provided evidence that there is a link between climate change and sea level rise. Then they are explaining the significance and importance of their findings. They are saying that this is one of the most comprehensive studies done on this topic to date. Then they are finishing the passage with the future implications of their work. They are saying that their findings will help coastal communities with infrastructure planning in the future. Here's a slightly different example. The authors are starting the conclusion paragraph with the study objective, which is to test for allergies in patients with titanium dental implants. Then they are listing the contributions of their work. They are saying that they have made 3 contributions. Number 1, they have shown how to identify the symptoms of titanium allergy. Number 2, how to conduct tests to confirm the allergy. And number 3, how to manage the allergies in the long term. Then they are finishing the paper off with some information about the future implications of their work. They are saying that the findings of their work are very important for the clinical management of patients with titanium allergy. I hope you found the presentation useful. See you in the next video. If you have any questions, please drop a message below. We will answer it as soon as possible. If you are interested in watching the extended version of this training course and learn more about research and academic writing, please visit our Learning Academy. You can find the link in the description below. If you still haven't installed Ref and Write software, please do it. It comes with referencing tools, plagiarism checkers, paraphrasing tools, an academic phrase bank, and many other useful features to help you write your research papers and thesis. You can sign up for free using the link below in the description. Finally, please subscribe to our channel to get future updates. Bye for now.